Greetings everyone, we are from Group 5 and today we are going to have a short presentation on mass transit. In modern urban cities, mass transit has become a basic necessity. Mass transit, or known as public transportation, is the movement of large group of people from one place to another using buses or trains. Mass transit normally runs on a fixed route with set embarkation and disembarkation points with a scheduled timetable, unlike a private automobile which can be used to travel anywhere and anytime. Yet, mass transit brings more benefits to urban cities compared to private automobiles.
So the first reason why I say mass transit is beneficial to the humankind is because it reduces the amount of pollution that we are releasing to the atmosphere or anywhere on the earth. So the pollution that I'm going to talk about right now is gas pollution. As we all know, the more the number of vehicles on the road, the more the amount of greenhouse gases that we are going to emit to the atmosphere. So the greenhouse gases will cause greenhouse effects, and as we all know, we need to reduce the effect of greenhouse gases by now, or the consequences will be devastating on the future. So when we do a comparison between a car and a bus, like the car is fully occupied and the bus is also fully occupied, a bus only emits 14 pounds of carbon dioxide, while on the other hand, the car emits around 89 pounds of carbon dioxide. Apart from gas pollution, there's also sound pollution that can be related to the number of vehicles on the road. So for an example, a car horn produce 19 decibels and a bus produce 100 decibels. But again, a car can only occupy 4 to 6 people, but a bus can occupy around 40 to 80 people.
Most people believe that mass transit are most likely favorable because it is time-saving and provides an affordable fare system. This is where public transport users have a significant amount of time throughout their traveling without any interferences from the outer environment. In the interval, passengers can do minor things such as reading, completing their unfinished tasks on their laptops, and entertained by various videos on YouTube. Hence, traveling for private vehicle users can be usually detained with traffic jams, roadblocks, or even accidents in which the driver has to keep an eye on the busy road. And for the usage of public transit benefits the public by saving a significant amount of money too. So users can save their money for other purposes such as whole household terms and paying tax. And also they can avoid unnecessary expenditures such as in filling up petrol, car maintenance, parking fee and road tax, which is considered as a fundamental aspect for a vehicle owner. So most of the public transit fare system is updated to an organized paying system, as the public prefers more cashless payment. This convenient initiative will reduce the usage of cash notes as they can use for other purposes. Nevertheless, it is proven that mass transit really benefits the public in terms of saving money and time.
Besides, another claim that I can make to prove that mass transit is really beneficial to the public is, as the mass transit contributes to the process of reducing number of deaths due to accidents. As we all know that by referring to any reasonable fraction of capacity, mass transit vehicles carry a far higher passenger load per unit of weight and volume compared to the private vehicles. And the government are encouraging people to travel using mass transit because the situation helps them to reduce the number of cars in roads, which can make huge difference in the rising number of death due to accidents.
Somehow, people do not ensure that using public transportation become an efficient way to save their own life while traveling on highways. A good mass transit encourages many high-risk drivers such as teenagers, older drunks, to stay off the road to save innocent people's lives. People who usually travel using mass transit realize and admit that public transportation is much more safer compared to the own private vehicles. In my point of view, mass transit produces a safe traveling experience to each one of the passengers unless accidents occur due to unsolved reasons like the weather condition. However, mass transit still offers a right choice for people as it prepares a comfortable zone for passengers to feel safe and sound while traveling.
Moving on, mass transit modernizes urban cities by requiring lesser land compared to private automobiles. For example, a shopping mall can easily accommodate at least 1,000 private automobiles. With that much of precious land, it can be used for other basic necessities. Urban city is a very dense and space-efficient city, thus utilizing mass transit is a more logical approach than compared to private automobiles. Private automobiles also causes traffic congestion.
During this pandemic, COVID-19 has spread almost everywhere in the globe since early 2020. Although public transit are safe and favorable, but most of the users are afraid to travel because they assume that transit station becomes one of the possible areas to be exposed to the virus. That is not the case here, and despite the fact about the spreading of the virus, public transit users can travel frequently in any public transit if they practice social distancing, as they can prevent the spreading of the virus. Besides that, the World Health Organization also recommends the public to follow some standard operation procedures during this pandemic, such as wearing a mask, hand sanitizing, and also avoid close contact with other individuals, to be practiced as the new normal. As a peroration, public transport users can safely travel if they get to use with social distancing and other standard operation procedures during this tough situation.
Although mass transit is safer than cars, but the challenge of the provision of an adequate level of transit infrastructures and service level become the main reason for why people are not interested in using public transportation. For example, people have complained about mass transportation system because they can be crowded, uncomfortable, dirty, and unreliable by using mass transit such as bus and train. Some of the organizations failed to limit the number of passengers like below 44 or only 44 due to earn more profit from a single trip. In my personal view, I firmly believe that public thoughts will turn positive towards the mass transit and they show more interest to the public transportation compared to their own private transport if the authorized organization takes some immediate action, which I said before, to make mass transit more popular and beneficial to the public.
So as for the conclusion, we already know that mass transit always been beneficial to mankind since we are using it. So we as human beings are becoming greedy day by day by destroying our earth. So one of the way to save our earth is to use mass transit. So in an article, it is stated that the global greenhouse gases emission plucked by roughly 2.4 billion tons this year, that is about 7% drops from 2019 and the largest decline on record. That is due to lockdown that all the countries around the world that did during the pandemic. So I guess there's no reason for us to do another lockdown for us to reduce the amount of greenhouse gases. We can simply do it just by using mass transit. And as we all know, number of accidents that occurs on the road is keep on raising due to the personal vehicles that we use, but the number of accidents that caused by the public transport is much more lesser than the vehicles that we use. So start using public transport and love your life. And one of the way to lessen our expenses in the future also would be by using mass transit. So that's all from us. Thank you.